Welcome back to the channel, guys. Today I am doing this session with a great sense of loss and a heart filled with grief. Yesterday we lost our beloved Bharat Ratna Atalji, a great orator, a great poet, and a statesman of the highest order. He might no more be with us in physical form, but he is with us in spirits, guiding us through his ideas, visions, and thoughts, and inspiring us to work relentlessly and selflessly in nation building. So I am dedicating this session to him. With that, let's move to the first news of the day. NDRF director says that 23 additional NDRF teams will be deployed to Kerala. Now this is a repetitive news. The Kerala crisis is going on, but however, we have a new thing to learn today. NDRF, what is NDRF? NDRF stands for National Disaster Response Force. It's a specialized force for the purpose of specialist response to a threatening disaster situation. So it's a specialized force, guys. You know, they are actually trained to handle disasters. And it has 12 battalions deployed based on vulnerability profile. What is vulnerability profile? They are deployed as per the vulnerability of the places. Now, some of the battalions are near Bihar, wherein every other year there is flood because of Kosi River. And a battalion is deployed in Odisha because of disasters due to cyclone, you know. So based on the vulnerability of the places, battalions are deployed. This is headed by Director General, who is an IPS officer. The responsible ministry is Ministry of Home Affairs. The NDRF comes under National Disaster Management Authority. And Prime Minister is the ex officio chairman, though it comes under Home Ministry. So please remember, Home Minister is not the head here. He is not the chairman. Prime Minister is the chairman here, though it comes under Ministry of Homes. Now, this has been formed under Disaster Management Act of 2005. So, it's a statutory body. All right. And as per the act, apart from setting up NDMA, that is National Disaster Management Authority, we also have a State Disaster Management Authorities, which is chaired by a Chief Minister, and a District Disaster Management Authority chaired by District Collector. So these can be asked in your prelims, which department belongs to which ministry and which department has its source from which act. So please remember this. The next one. Rupee slide continues to a new low, closes at 70.16. Again, another news which is already going on from a couple of days. Now we have two news here, the sub news of it. One, we have a positive, outlook to it, and then there is a challenging thing. What is positive news? Tea exporters to join industry delegation to Kazakhstan. Now, as there is a depreciation, our products in the international market will be cheaper. Hence, Kazakhstan is likely to become the next big market for Indian tea. All right. Now, who are India's competitors there? We have China, Sri Lanka, and Kenya will be competing with India now. Okay, now there is a challenge. India's oil import bill may jump by 26 billion because dollar has increased in its value. Buying oil will become much costlier now, and this will lead to increase in trade deficit. Trade deficit means importing more than what we export. Okay, now this trade deficit is already $18 billion for the month of July. Okay, and this will also affect foreign exchange reserves, which has already declined by $23 billion in last 4 months and stood at $402.7 billion as of August 3rd, 2018. So already foreign exchange reserves are declining. This might add to further decline. Okay, so please remember this. Next one. UPI 2.0 unveiled. What is UPI? UPI stands for United Payment Interface, and it has been upgraded to the next version of 2.0. What is UPI all about? It's a single mobile application to access bank accounts for e-payments. Okay, now using that, through your mobile phone, you can do your transaction. And Bheem app is built using the UPI interface. Okay, so what is this new thing? What is this new version actually has? What is the important additional feature in 2.0? Now here, user can link the overdraft account also. Now what is overdraft? Overdraft means asking bank to make the payment to the merchant now and committing to the bank that you will pay it later. It is just like taking a short-term loan from the bank. Okay, now this feature is also included. And the older feature had only linking the current account and savings account. Okay, now the new feature has all the three. Now, what are the advantages of UPI? It would push our economy towards cashless digital economy, right? And financial inclusion, wherein the people from all the strata of the society will be able to involve themselves in banking system. Illiterate, literate, poor or rich, you know, regardless, everyone has a smartphone now with an internet connection, right? Most of them at least. So the inclusion of all of them in the banking system would be much, much greater. Okay, now this will eventually lead to curbing of black money. All right. Now, UPI is developed by National Payment Corporation of India. So please remember this. These things might be asked in your preliminary examination. Okay, so the next one. LIGO project may come up in India. What is LIGO? LIGO stands for Light Interferometer Gravitational Wave Observatory. Now, what it does? It detects even the faintest ripples from cosmic explosions millions of light years away. Now, if there are any collisions between two stars or black holes, there will be a massive explosion light years away. But however, by the time the wave reaches our Earth, it will be very faint, you know, very sensitive. So to actually record those sensitive faintest ripples is a big challenge. And LIGO does that. So there are three detectors already, two in Hanford and one in Livingston, both in USA. And they're planning to shift one of them in Hanford to India. And they're planning to do that in Hingoli district of Maharashtra. Now, right now, they are checking the feasibility as it needs extremely flat surface. Because as it is very sensitive, the machine is very sensitive, it needs an extremely flat surface. Now, this is a joint collaboration between LIGO Lab and LIGO India. And the department which is taking care of this is Department of Atomic Energy and Department of Science and Technology. It might be ready by 2025 with a budget of 1200 crores. Now, what are the useful things about this? Access to technology is one big thing, you know, which would have otherwise taken years to develop, right? Such a big technology, very costly first thing, and it would have taken much time. This is accessible to us right now, and our physicists and scientists would get an opportunity to learn and explore. And whatever we would learn from this technology can be employed in the future for next generation precision engineering industries. Okay, so please remember this. This can be, your question in mains as under science and technology or perhaps in prelims also. So the next one. Social media flooded with distress messages during Kerala crisis. Now this will take us to the write-up challenge. Okay, the challenge for the day is role of social media in disaster management. So please think about this, please ponder over it and deliberate on that and come up with an article with a good introduction, a good block, a mid block and a good conclusion. Let that be between 150 to 200 words and leave it in the comment section. Okay, so that is it for the day, guys. I hope it was useful to you. And I want to end this session with a poem of our beloved Atal ji. Kya haar mein, kya jeet mein, kinchit nahi bhayabheet mein, kartavya path par jo bhi mila, yah bhi sahi, wo bhi sahi. Vardaan nahi mangunga, ho kuch parhaar nahi manunga, parhaar nahi manunga. Thank you guys.